Why do you always do that thing?
Do what?
The thing you do when you're fighting. And the, like the, this thing that you do when you whip your hair when you're fighting with the arm and the hair and you do like a fighting pose. It's a fighting pose. You're a total pose.
What's shaking, my subscribers? Sturtzer here, and today we're doing Black Widow's drink. The inspiration for this drink comes from Age of Ultron. They are having a party in Tony Stark's tower. Natasha Romanoff makes Bruce Banner a drink, and you see her pour it out of the shaker into a martini glass, and it's red. So that's what we're basing it off of, and that's kind of all I've got to go off of, just the look of a drink. So I had pretty free rein to pick whatever ingredients I wanted. We're going to start with 1 bar spoon of Campari. Normally you start with like the cheapest ingredient, but if I put too much of this in, it can throw off the whole drink, so we're going to do this first. 1/2 ounce of lime juice. Then we got 6 blackberries. And you don't really need to do this, but I'm going to muddle. When you shake, the ice will probably muddle it enough and break it apart, but just to help it out. Ooh. 1 ounce of Rosa's grenadine. I usually use homemade, but Rosa's has a very pretty color, and that's what we're going for this drink. 1 ounce of an unsweetened cherry juice, or tart cherry juice. 1/2 ounce of a black raspberry liqueur. And 2 ounces of vodka. Give it a good shake. In the movie, they had just a plain martini glass, but my wife found this pretty one, so I figured we'd use that. And you're gonna want to double strain to catch those blackberry pieces. There we have Black Widow's drink, and it's going to be called the Red Ledger. Let's give it a try. It's so fruity, and I don't know. I haven't had a drink before that has such like a berry flavor, and this one does, but it's not like an overly sweet berry. It tastes like you're eating blackberries, like fresh blackberries. The first time I made it, the Campari kind of added like a little bit of a dry finish. I don't know if my blackberries were a bit sweeter to kind of offset that a bit more, but it's still delicious. It's super easy to drink. You would not know there's alcohol in it.
That's really good. It definitely has a really good berry flavor to it. But like you said, like not in an overly sweet way. I don't know. I think you encapsulated it nicely. Sweet blood.
It does look like blood. It's not quite the right color based on that scene.
Yeah. It looks an awful lot like blood on the camera.
It really just looks like blood. You could, if you didn't want to use this as a Black Widow drink, you could make this Halloween themed drink and it would be perfect.
I think it has like a punch.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Oh, and it probably would work great as a punch, honestly. Just get a large amount of all the ingredients, and you could switch out Chambord for like a knockoff raspberry liqueur. That's what I originally used. I just recently got this, and it's just as good. Well, it's black raspberry.
Oh, gotcha.
That's what it says on the bottle.
Black raspberry?
That's what it says on the bottle.
Just blackberry?
It says all natural black raspberry liqueur, product of France.
What the hell are they doing in France?
Oh my. So I don't know if that's blackberry or raspberry, just they mix the two. I don't know. I used D'Amour brand raspberry liqueur, and it's delicious still. It's cheaper than this. Not quite as good if you were to drink it straight or like have just a few ingredients, but with the amount that there are, it works just as good and it's delicious. If you enjoyed this, feel free to like and subscribe. Find me on Facebook and Instagram. Give me some drink recommendations if you have any. I'd love to hear what ideas you've got. Can't wait to share a sip with you in another video.